Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we have seen the basic set of APIs. Now we will go to our API spec and see what we are going to create. So we need to do these few APIs, like we should be able to create post, update post and delete post, and we should be able to get post based on user ID. Okay, so these specific APIs we have to create, like here we are getting user by user ID, creating user, and we have one particular API which is actually giving us the post for a particular user ID. So API user, here we will be passing user ID in the route parameter, right? So this API is actually to create a post by user, because if you are creating a post, then we also need a user information, because we need to populate the user information in the post route. So you can see in the post we have the user object, user reference. So while you create a post, we have to update this user also, and once the post is created, we also need to update the post array in the user reference. So these two things. So what is important is creating user is simple. We are able to get the create user done successfully, get user, and we are just converting it to post, passing the body, something like this, and we are able to create a user without any obstacle. We are able to create a user. Now once this user ID is created, we are initially getting post empty array, right? Now how we can push the newly created post for this user? So for that we have to create a post, and once the post is created, we have to update the user and also update the post with that user who has created it. So there are three things we have to follow. So we already created that route here, that in the user routes, we have this specific route. What it is doing is, it is actually creating a new post. First thing, okay, once the post is created, we are updating user, because we have to add the reference, and we have to push the newly created post ID into the user, and finally we have to update post and add user reference there, that this is the user which has created you. Okay, that we can do in the first phase itself while creating a new post. Okay, now we'll see this create task. What we are doing here is post create, and we will try to clean and refactor this in the better way. Okay, so this API call will be something like this, API posts, sorry, API users, and here will be user ID and then post. Right, so this user ID we have to get from request parameter. We got the user ID, and this is the payload of a post which has contains title and content. Okay, now we are calling this method create. Now this is important. What all things we are doing here is, first we are creating a post. Okay, before doing that, we can also do one thing, is this is the post payload. So post.user we can set, and we are already getting user ID. That means we have set the user ID for the post who is creating this user, creating this post, and then we are doing post.create and passing the payload. Right, this will contain a title, content, user, and once the post is created, we are getting the ID of that post. Okay, and we have the user ID already there. With this user ID, I mean, we can do this validation later. I mean, currently we are just appending this user ID without doing validation, but it can be three-step process: create a post, update a user, update a post. Here we are creating a post with the user ID already. So post is created, then we are getting the post ID, and we already have a user ID, so we are trying to find user exist. If user exists, we are getting the, we are updating the user with a new post ID which that user has created. So here we are getting the existing post and pushing the new ID you have created. Okay, otherwise what you need to do is, if you don't want it to assign the user here, then you can do is, we already got the user, we already have the user ID from here. You can just assign the post dot user here and then return post.save. That's it. Now let's see how it works. So create post. So title test. So here we are creating post, and you can see that user which I'm specifying here. So that user has already created lot many posts, so it will keep adding that in the array. Okay, we can get this with some another user. So I created a new user. I'm creating a post now. This should be empty with only one ID now, because now user is created. We have added a new post ID in the posts array. Alright, you can keep adding. And while getting a post, we have to populate the user information. So this magically happens with a MongoDB. Here we are trying to do get post by ID. So if you look at the code in the post route, we are doing this post ID, get post by ID, find by ID. And here we are doing populate. This populate will help us to populate the user information, which is a reference with the post collection, right? User is a reference with the post collection. So we can do populate user, and we are able to get the user information with the post. So here, this user has done a lot of post, we can just get it. So this post, and whoever has written this post, that user information is here. Similarly, while doing a get user, here we should be having one method which should be returning a user information. There also we should be able to do this populate thing. Here is API users user ID. Now we'll see what is this, and we'll fix this. So here is our user routes, and what we are trying to do is users list, right? This method we are calling. We can do a better debugging. Here we are doing user list.list, and we are doing user.find. Okay, so we have a user collection, and we are running a find operation on this. If I just make an empty condition there and do a populate with user, I want to populate post also. All the users, whatever I created, they should come up with the post which they have created. Okay, so we are calling list. Let's see the flow now. Or we can also call the find by ID. In that also we can populate the post. This is specific ID. Here is our user routes. From there we are calling list and get. We'll see what is there. It should be params. This is a mistake we are doing, because user ID we are getting in the params, not in the query params. User ID, we got query params. Okay, now you can see we are able to populate posts, right? So we are getting the IDs. Let's see, in our services we have user services. It should be posts, I think, because it's a, this is the column name we have. This is coming up now. Clear? Now either you do a get user or get all users. You are getting all data together, right? We are creating a post, creating a user, and then we are doing a get user by ID or either get all users, right? We are able to get the post collection with the user data itself. Okay, this is the first user. These are the second user. So we have created lot many users, right? So this is how we can actually create a embedded results using just populate thing, right? Here we are creating users. So these all APIs are working now. Find one, list, find by ID, delete user by ID, that we can try simply. So what I will do, I will push this code. Now we have achieved almost all the things. Create user, create post, get post by ID, create user, get user by ID. Now, this is a promise based implementation. If you see in the controllers, we are doing a lot of promise.then chaining, right? Now, can we convert this into async await, and can we write this clean code? If we write it with the async await, we don't have to write lot many lines of code. We can just do things in just a one single line. Await async we have to use. Okay, in the next video, I will transform this whole code into async await, and we'll see.